We started.
Yes. Hi there. It's still refreshing somewhere, but let's say that it's starting. Okay. Hi, everyone.
Okay.
Yes,
There it
this is
is.
live. Hi, guys. Hi, everyone. Good to not seeing you, but I hope you see us though. So this is Mia, a very cool student of mine.
Bonjour.
And bonjour, and she started learning French pretty recently, actually, only a couple of weeks ago. And she's putting a lot of effort and passion into that, so I thought she was a perfect model to help me today for this class together. So actually, the class is more going to be about Mia and I. So I will teach her the way I would teach a private class, and the idea is that you are in to me in Mia's shoes, and then you try to do the same as she does, to make your own sentences when she's thinking of her sentences, and seeing if you can improve the way you would say things, or find another perspective, or look for your own vocab. Anyway, so Mia is going in to help me feel you maybe more in a class right now. And as for questions, I will use the last 5 10 minutes of the live class to look at the questions, because I think it's better if we stay focused on what we are saying. And again, it's a beginner class now, so we will not tackle very complicated problems like what is the difference between passé composé and imparfait, or when to use futur simple, or whatever. So we will stay with the present tense, doing pretty simple things, and it's going to be a good opportunity for you to check where you're at with your French language. So I hope you will enjoy it. And just Mia, if you want to say a couple of words about you before or not. Okay, so perfect. So let's dive into it. Okay, alors, first of all, alors, this is a material that I love using. Do you know what is it? Tu sais? Tu connais?
Qu'est-ce que c'est?
Qu'est-ce que c'est? Très
Qu'est-ce?
bien. Okay, so Mia just asked me what it was in a very good way. Qu'est-ce que c'est? Alors, c'est une réglette. C'est une réglette.
Tu
Une.
sais? C'est tout. Oh, c'est une réglette.
Yes, okay. So I'm making the
You made the
liaison.
T from
Yeah.
the.
Exactly.
Oh. But when you do c, c-e-s-t, right? But you don't pronounce the T regularly. Because we always
No.
say c.
Exactement.
But then you
C'est.
add the tu. That's what threw me off. Because it's
Exactement.
une réglette.
Exactement. So if I put all of the words on my hand like this, so exactly, we would have the C apostrophe here connected with the A. And then the liaison, yes, with the T is to be pronounced with the une that follows. C'est une réglette. Ok, encore une fois?
Okay.
Once more?
C'est une réglette.
Ok, c'est ça. But if you say only une réglette, like a block or a rod or whatever, you don't need the T.
Une réglette.
Une réglette, ok. A small thing about your pronunciation of the une. So, ok, much better. Encore? Once more? Une, ok, this is perfect. Ok. I sometimes hear something a bit more loose. Ou, if you are looser with the U, you fall into the U sound, actually.
Okay.
So keep, so you're right, the
Right
lips are
here.
fine forward, but U, it's a bit more close than for U, which is a bit more open. So une.
Une.
Très bien, parfait. Ok, super. C'est une réglette. Ok, très bien. Alors, de quelle couleur
De
est
quelle?
cette réglette? So I'm asking you the question this time.
De
De quelle couleur
quelle?
est cette réglette?
C'est une bleue.
Ouais, parfait. C'est une bleue. Ok, très bien. You can say that. C'est une bleue. If you want to extend a bit, you can repeat réglette. Where would you add it?
C'est une règle bleue.
Ouais, très bien. C'est une réglette bleue. Ok, parfait. And if you want to switch a bit, instead of saying c'est, saying something kind of equivalent, have she is blue. Because réglette is feminine, so it sounds off
Oh.
in English, but in French, this is what we would say.
Oh, elle c'est une bleue.
Alors, elle, c'est une bleue. You have a bit too many words here. You would need to get rid of two words. Do you have an idea which ones?
Elle.
Elle. Okay. Let's keep
une.
It. And une, we're going to get rid
elle
of that.
C'est bleu.
Elle, c'est bleu. What is your subject here? Your queen.
It's the... Oh, the queen,
the queen
is elle.
Elle, très bien, okay. What's C apostrophe here?
That's the officer. The...
E is the officer.
Oh.
E is the verb officer. We have a specific vocab between us to talk about grammar.
Okay.
But, so... E is être, right?
Mm.
So it's your officer.
So what's the... Where did the C come from?
The C apostrophe is another subject. When you were using it in your previous sentence,
mm-hmm.
c'est une, I'm going to start like this, c'est une réglette bleue.
Mm-hmm.
So, est is your verb officer here,
mm-hmm.
and si apostrophe is your subject.
Okay.
So, you cannot have two subjects in
mm-hmm.
one sentence.
Mm-hmm.
So, if you use elle, actually you use elle instead of si apostrophe.
Okay.
You substitute these two, depending on your perspective.
Okay.
I'm going to go back to what is the difference between the two sentences right after you finish this one, okay?
Okay.
So let's get rid of c'est and let's get rid of of
une,
exactement.
Alors. Elle est bleue.
Elle est bleue, parfait. Okay, so you have two ways here.
Mm-hmm.
C'est une réglette bleue ou elle est bleue.
Elle est bleue.
Okay, my initial question was de quelle couleur est la réglette?
La réglette de quelle couleur?
De quelle couleur? So,
what is the color of the block?
Anyway, so what do you think is better? C'est une réglette bleue, or elle est bleue?
Elle est bleue.
Elle est bleue. Exactement.
Mm-hmm.
Both are fine. We understand, but the second option is a better answer to the specific question
mm-hmm.
about the color.
So is the first one a little like elementary, like? Like a kid or a baby you're talking to, or
not
or
really.
Like in a sentence, or
For c'est une réglette bleue
mm-hmm.
for this one, it's just another perspective. Like if you say elle est bleue, you are more talking about the color. If you say c'est une réglette bleue, you're more looking at all of it, the fact that it's that it's a block and it's blue.
It's blue. Okay.
So it's just a different message. Both are totally fine. It depends on what you really want to say.
Mm.
But if you want to answer directly and straightforwardly to the question I asked, maybe the second one a bit shorter, only about the information of the color is a bit better.
Okay.
Ça va? Okay. Très bien. No, you asked me the color
okay.
of another thing.
Let's see. De quelle couleur une réglette?
Mm-hmm. Alors, encore une fois, almost there.
De quelle couleur
mm-hmm.
une
réglette? So you're missing something here.
De quelle couleur?
Ouais.
I don't know.
You have what? Color,
mm-hmm.
kind of. Then,
c'est?
Alors,
est
exactement.
De
est.
Quelle.
De
quelle couleur est une réglette?
Okay. This is grammatically correct.
Mm-hmm.
But if you use une here, it's a bit like a rod. What color is a rod? So it would be a bit more in the air.
Mm-hmm.
It's about this specific one that you have here. I never taught you that. You don't know that. So that's fine. You cannot know it. You cannot invent French language like that. Okay. So here it's set. So we pronounce it set and it's written C-E-double-T-E. Set.
Okay.
We go with the double T and the E at the end because it's feminine. Block in French is
because
feminine.
The block is feminine.
Exactly.
And you're saying that the this becomes feminine because the block is feminine.
We have several ways to say this in
okay.
French, one feminine way and one masculine way.
Okay.
Actually, we have two masculine ways, but I'm not going to talk
okay,
about
we'll
it right
go there.
Now. One masculine way would be exactly the same pronunciation as the feminine part, and one masculine way would not be exactly the same pronunciation. This is just what I'm going to tell you now, okay? All but
right.
you can remember set and you're good.
Okay. So, de Quelle couleur est cette règle?
Parfait, très bien, super.
Okay. Let me see
Non,
if I
non,
can get it here.
yes.
De quelle couleur est cette règle?
Super, très bien, c'est parfait, très
Mm-hmm.
bien. Alors, if we just work a bit on the intonation
Yeah.
here, de quelle couleur? Alors, so I'm gonna say it, and I would like you to try to hear or feel if there are some battements, some syllables that I am insisting a bit more on, or that would be. So yes, let's do that first, and then we will
Okay.
do that. De quelle couleur est cette réglette?
De quelle couleur est cette réglette?
De quelle couleur est cette réglette?
Okay, what was your question?
My question was, do you hear like I would have insisted a bit more on one word compared to the other
It does
ones?
have the de quelle couleur est une réglette.
Oui,
So it's like every other word
ok,
or every
kind
other.
of, yes, ok, très bonne idée, very good
Is
idea.
that syllable?
Yeah,
Nice.
I said battement because you
Right.
know my approach. I'm
Right.
gonna say battement because it's a class to you and they can catch up maybe later.
Okay.
But let's say battement, I think it's better for your understanding. So, exactement. De quelle couleur? So, my voice goes a bit
De quelle
upper at
couleur?
the end of
Yeah, right.
couleur, exactement. Et cette réglette? Ok, so le set réglette, I think it's more the rhyme here that would make it the set a bit more up, but I would say that réglette is a bit more important here than set for the last word. And so because you said it, we go up. In English, you kind of stress syllables, you know, and make it longer, or you insist a bit more. The time you dedicate to each syllable can vary in English. In French, it does not change that much, but we kind of raise the voice to the important part on the important words in the sentence. So, de quelle couleur est cette réglette? So, it would be on the heure of couleur and on the last part of
Well,
réglette.
like the last part is a question, so
Yes,
réglette.
also, yeah, réglette, yeah. It's also because it's a question, you're right,
Right.
totally.
Okay.
This is really why. So, but couleur would be the most impactive word in this sentence. Do you have an idea why?
Because I'm asking you what color.
Exactly. So we have the trend to really put forward the insist on the words that are the most important in the sentence. I think it's pretty like intuitive, but it's also important to notice them and to be aware of that as well. Okay. So de quelle couleur est cette réglette? Et cette
Okay, let me
réglette,
try again.
encore une fois.
De quelle couleur est cette réglette?
Ok, c'est bien. Ok, très bien. Parfait. Cette réglette est verte. Cette réglette est verte. Now, I'm
Okay,
gonna.
cette réglette. Oui.
Cette
Cette réglette
réglette est
est
verte.
verte. I was just confused because I remember I was just looking at the last lesson. The a and ver is
Ah
in
oui.
two words,
Ok.
not okay. Got it.
Yeah. It's yeah. Verte.
Ver
Yeah,
is
verte.
green.
Ouais, exactement.
Okay.
Green. Ok. And can you tell me where I did the liaison here?
Could you say that sentence
Cette
again?
réglette est verte. Cette réglette est verte.
What was the third one?
Cette réglette est. Alors. I'm pronouncing it in a row, okay?
Yeah.
Cette réglette est verte.
Where is the
Ouais.
cette réglette the t
Ouais.
and réglette
T. Ouais, réglette, exactement.
so they
Cette
blend
réglette
réglette
est
verte.
verte. Exactement. I'm pronouncing the T of réglette at the same time as the E that is right after. Cette réglette est verte. Très bien.
Okay.
Ok. So very important also to think of that. Now, do you think you could ask me? So I'm influencing a bit your choice, but about these two here.
Okay. Both? Okay. De quelle couleur? Okay. It's these versus this.
Yes, you're gonna need that. You cannot know, I'm gonna tell. But I'm more interested by the
Comment on
off.
dit
Alors, très bien.
these en français?
Très bien, parfait. On dit C. C-E-S. C. So you remember that the set was the feminine part. So we get rid of the double T-E and we add an S instead. So C-E-S for C. C. It's the same pronunciation as the letter C, actually, that we say C in French. That's it. And it's the same pronunciation also as C apostrophe EST. Almost, kind of.
Right, c'est.
Almost the same.
OK.
C.
Alright. De quelle couleur c'est de règle?
Ouh, très bien. Ok. You just forgot one small word. Do you
That I
have
did it before?
any? Actually, when you asked me the question about only
The
one word,
one?
yeah, it was the
OK.
same that you forgot.
De quelle couleur? I forgot. De quelle couleur? C'est. Oh, et c'est de règle. Right?
Alors
Et.
oui, est is singular though.
OK. Et. Et.
Et it's the singular form of to be, of
Être
être. Ouais, alors être is the infinitive, it's the title of the
Okay.
officer verb, yes.
Oh, so it would be like a they, right? Nous.
Alors they.
Nous, vous.
Alors, you are looking at the subject here. We need the conjugation. It would be the conjugated form for they. You're right. For il or elle in the plural.
So
It's super irregular. If you kind of forgot that, it's
It's
okay.
not nous vous nous sommes baise
Why are you calling? Sorry, someone is calling.
Wait, I'm just like picturing it's je suis tu as
Tu
tu
es.
es il elle Et
Très bien. Nous sommes. This
nous
one is super
sommes,
irregular. Ouais.
okay.
Nous sommes.
Vous
Vous êtes.
êtes.
Ouais.
So is it
Alors it would be for you. Vous is what's that in English? Vous?
it would be plural you.
Ouais.
Oh, so
But you're not vous. You're not saying vous to the
this
regular.
is plural this,
Yes.
plural
Plural
we,
they. Plural
plural
they.
they. Oh,
It's they.
on. Ils sont.
Son. Super. Parfait.
Okay.
You got it on your own. Très
Okay.
bien. Super Mia. Parfait.
So, de quelle couleur sont ces deux règles?
C'est parfait. Super. Très très bien. De quelle couleur sont ces deux réglettes? C'est
Okay.
parfait. Encore une fois, with the floor. You got it.
De quelle couleur? De quelle couleur sont ces deux réglettes?
Super. Sont ces deux, alors, de quelle couleur sont ces deux réglettes? Here, you can insist only at the end of
Des
réglettes and
réglettes.
you're good. Ouais.
De quelle couleur sont cette sont cette deux réglettes?
Parfait. Très très bien. Super good. She only started a couple of weeks ago. Really. C'est super good. Très bien. Ok. Ces deux réglettes sont vertes. Vert clair et vert foncé. Just if you want some vocab
Okay.
for, but that's fine. We'll move on to that. Ok, très bien, parfait, super. Let's move away from the colors and then do a bit more of actions. Do you remember if I do that? Would you be able to describe what I just did? Ouais, ok.
Elle prend.
Alors you're talking to me though.
Oh,
Let's.
yeah, tu prends une règle.
Parfait, très bien. Prononciation here. So prendre is the infinitive title of verb, you're right. But can you pronounce, do you have to pronounce all of the letters?
The last letter doesn't.
Okay, so can you do it again, please?
Prendre.
Ouais, prend, that's it. Okay. And remember this nasal one that we have here. So prend is P-R-E-N-D-S. So the D-S are totally silent. And the E-N work together. So because E attracts the N and make it a nasal sound, then you do not even close your mouth. Because if you close your mouth, you're going to want to say N. It's difficult to refrain. Being an English speaker,
prend.
Exactement.
Prend.
Keep it open and then you cannot be confused. Okay.
Okay.
Très bien, donc prends. Très bien.
Te prends une règle.
Parfait, très bien. And then, so this is the first action. You already said it. Then, if I do that, would you be able to tell what I'm doing?
Te me prends une règle.
Oh, this is interesting actually. This is correct. This is not what I did, but this is correct. What you just said. Tu me prends une réglette. So I'm going to give you a good situation for that. Let's say that réglette is, I don't know which, like orange juice. We are, unfortunately we can, but at a bar together and you want some orange juice. And then you can ask, if you replace réglette by orange juice. Can you repeat your sentence, please? Orange juice, but I just don't know. Do you know how to say orange juice? I just
Orange fruit.
Ah, alors, juice, it's almost the same. Orange, tu as raison. Orange is orange, perfect. And juice would be jus. J-U-S. And then we say juice of orange in French. This is the way we say it.
Jus à orange.
Alors, A would not be of.
A is at.
Ouais.
Yeah.
We didn't practice it that much.
I remember writing it, but I don't remember
De. And because orange starts with a vowel, we're going to do like this.
So
we remove the E and we put an apostrophe. And
D'orange.
Jus d'orange. And this would be masculine. Un jus d'orange.
Okay.
Once more.
Un jus d'orange.
Parfait. Très bien. So, you replace that. So you said, do you remember your sentence?
Tu me prends un d'orange.
Un.
Deux.
Alors, d'orange est here.
Un jus d'orange.
Ouais, très bien. Un jus d'orange. Tu me prends un jus d'orange. Très bien. This sentence.
Prend un de. Wait, I missed it. Tu me prends un jus d'orange.
Parfait. Très bien, c'est parfait.
Okay.
So this situation refers to that. Oui, pas de problème. Oui. S'il vous plaît, un jus d'orange et un jus d'abricot. Hop, un jus d'orange. So this situation would be more like, can you take this for me, or can you bring me something like that? Can you bring me an orange juice?
So when you're doing that.
Yes, this is me giving it to you. So we're not going to shorten. We're going to use a réglette again in this sentence first, and then this action is donner. So yes. So just try something simple to start. You give me the block.
Okay. Tu me donnes une règle.
Ok, très bien. How do you spell donner?
D-O-N-N-E.
Ok, with or without accent?
Without.
Ok, so only one battement here, one beat.
Done.
Yeah.
Because it's two ends, we say the N.
Yes, exactly. Very good question. When two ends are together, they kind of detach from the vowel surrounding, and they are not associated with the O that is before to be nasal. They just are pronounced the way they should be as proper ends.
Okay.
You're totally right. But we do not hear E at the end because it's a single E without accent and without er.
Okay.
So if you would have had an accent or er, then you should have said donné. But here, because it's single e, silent, we just pronounce the n before and that's it, done.
Okay,
très bien. And just, I'm a bit insisting with that, but it would not be une in this situation. Because
là.
Mouais,
là.
Exactement,
mm-hmm.
encore une fois. Once
okay.
more, please.
Tu me donnes la règle.
Parfait, très très bien. Okay, so the first action, so can you now please say the action at the same time I'm doing them, please?
Okay, let's do it. I already forgot the first word. Tu. Tu me donnes.
Alors, first action, it's this one.
Tu. Oh.
The two sentences.
Oh, okay. Tu prends une règle.
Parfait.
Tu me donnes la règle.
Parfait. Super.
Okay.
C'est ça? Super good. Okay. And now, because French language do not really like repetition and saying the same word several times, do you have an idea how to make one sentence out of these two, shortening a bit the second part? You can also think of this now, actually.
So, you said tu me donnes. Tu me donnes. Oui?
Tu me donnes. If you say that,
tu
it's you give me.
Oh.
You would miss the it, you give it to me.
Tu. Je ne sais pas.
Très bien, super, parfait. Alors, we are going to reuse your second sentence and you're going to figure out from that. The second sentence was tu me donnes la réglette. We want to get rid of réglette. So
okay.
This one goes. Then, what can be convenient or confusing, depending on the perspective, I prefer seeing the convenient side. La here, which is a speaker determiner,
female.
If we move it a bit further in the sentence, then it's transformed. It's not a speaker or determiner anymore. It's now a pronoun or a subking. Subking, exactly.
Tu me la règle. Oh, tu me la donnes.
Et voilà, très bien. Ok, tu me la donnes, parfait. So you get rid of réglette because we don't want repetition, and just changing the location of la changes its function in the sentence. So now you get the subking that you
see.
Were looking for.
I was wondering how, I'm like, well, okay, I was wondering how you, why would you keep repeating that phrase, like in the video you had, the chocolat de la sœur?
Ah oui, les chocolats de ma sœur.
De ma sœur?
Ouais.
It's like, well, when would you say it again? But I get it now. That's what you're
referring.
Okay.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay. Alors, encore une fois, now I would like you to say the sentences at the same time as I am doing the action, and you would shorten the second part.
Okay.
Okay.
So, tu prends une règle, tu me la donnes.
Parfait. Super. Très très bien,
okay.
Mia. Ça va?
Oui.
Tu as des questions?
Non.
Ça va? Ok. So now, before we move on to a small conversation, let's switch perspective. Let's, you do the action.
Ok.
And you are telling what you are doing.
Ok.
You use je this
the
time.
The long one? Je?
You can, we will do step by step. So
okay.
You can do the first action. You say
okay.
what you're doing at the same time. Then the second action.
Mm-hmm.
You say it at the same time, and then we will shorten and make one big sentence with the subkings at the end.
Okay. Je prends une règle.
Très bien.
Je te donne une règle.
Une?
Une. Non, la
règle. Très bien. Parfait. Très
okay.
bien. The same without réglette.
Okay, okay.
Only once.
Je prends une réglette, je te la donne.
C'est parfait, très très
okay.
bien. Ok. Elle prend une réglette et elle me la donne. And we could go over and over with the different subjects, queens or whatever, and it would be pretty interesting to
Okay.
practice all
Yeah.
this. Good, you did a great job.
Oh, I'm
Thank you. No,
sweating.
I know I'm asking you a lot.
No, it's
I know. It feels good, right? Très bien.
good.
Okay. So, réglettes are very convenient because these are only vocabs. I mean, you can replace that with anything. I did it with the oranges to make me understand the situation. But actually, no matter what is the vocab you want to use, réglettes is pretty convenient to work from concrete and tangible situations. Okay. Now, because with learning French, it's always very important to reactivate and to practice. We've been working on a small conversation with Mia lately. And I would like her to be able to maybe reactivate a bit the sentences that we practice
Okay,
together.
I'm
So,
gonna look at my book.
yes, you can use your notes, of course. No, everyone can use whatever. Alors, salut, moi c'est Adèle. Et toi?
Salut, moi c'est Mia.
What am I asking? Yes, j'habite à San Francisco. Et toi?
J'habite San Francisco aussi.
Parfait, très bien. Et quelle est ta nationalité?
Je suis philippine. Et toi?
Et moi? Moi, je suis française. Je viens de Paris. Alors, did we go further than that? Oui. You wanted to ask
Oh,
the
yeah,
question.
oui, c'est cool.
C'est cool.
Quel est ton travail?
Alors, prononciation ici?
Quel est ton travail? Travail.
Travail.
Oh, travail.
Ouais, the A-I-L here are gonna sound y. It's not as
Travail.
intuitive as some others, but it's the L are rarely silent, even though final in French. It can happen, but most of the time they belong to the consonants that we would pronounce, even
Okay.
though there are not that many, you're right. Ok,
So,
encore une fois.
quel est ton travail? Bien,
Travail.
travail.
Très bien, ok. Je suis professeur de français. Et toi?
Je suis garde d'enfants.
Garde d'enfants.
Garde.
Ah ouais.
Garde. Garde
Oui.
d'enfants.
Alors, the difficulty here is that you have garde, you have a first D at the
Garde.
end, and then you start over again with the D after don.
Grade-font.
Garde. Alors, you
Grade-de.
say the R before the A, and it's the other way around. It's garde.
Garde-de-font.
Très bien. D'enfant. Ouais.
Garde-de-font.
Ouais, ça va, ça. Ok, ça c'est
OK.
bien. Ok, très bien. Ok, tu es garde d'enfant. I don't remember if we went
D'accord,
further.
tu préférais ça.
Ah ouais. Ah oui, voilà, c'est ça. Tu préfères travailler chez toi ou au bureau?
J'ai travaillé chez moi. Je n'ai pas de bureau.
Ouais, ok. Alors, there was a small thing here that I would like you to change when you say je n'ai pas bureau. You need to add a small word here. It's the word that goes with pas. Pas, pas.
Ne.
Alors, ne, ok. Alors, ok.
Gêne.
Alors, this is a good answer, actually. Ne,
Okay.
to pas. It goes together to form the negation. But we practice a bit once, maybe, that before each king, slash nouns, before each king in French, we need a speaker most of the time, to announce that the king walks
Oh,
in the
okay.
sentence.
Like
Like une,
une
un, exactement, c'est
or
ça.
le.
Très bien, exactement, oh le, exactement. But the thing is that when we're in a negative sentence, the speaker is kind of dropped and we replace it by another one. But we didn't practice that enough. So this is de.
De.
Pas de. Je n'ai
Ne
pas
pas de
de bureau.
bureau.
So instead of saying, normally you always have an article before a noun, you always have a speaker before a king. So je n'ai pas un bureau, for instance, ou le bureau, whatever. But because it's a negative sentence here, we just replace the speaker by de. And I think it's a good thing for the students to remember that, because even though sometimes un or une can work, it can happen, I would say that you are safe for
Is that
90%
D-E.
Ouais. You are safe for 90% of the situations. If you go with the, you're gonna be good. And I think that there's only about 10% of situations where un or une is accepted, and it's a recurrent mistake. So better remember the border. Je n'ai pas de bureau. Très bien. Ok. Et moi, je préfère travailler de chez moi. Ouais, I would say that as well.
Okay.
Je dirais ça aussi. Okay. Très bien. Ok. Right. Good. C'est bien. Bonne pratique. Pas de questions, ça va? No
pas
more
de,
questions.
Non,
non. So you see, pas de questions. It's the
pas
same
de.
When I'm asking you no questions. So we need the here instead of the article again.
You said pas de questions.
Pas de questions, ouais. Pas de questions. Ok.
Ah.
Très bien.
Ok.
So let's have a look at the chat quickly. If there are some, it will be here. No, there is no comment. Okay, so we're good. That's fine. It was the first time, so I hope it was fun. I hope you.
That was fun for me.
Yeah, that was fun for me as well. So at least
we didn't
lose our time. So I hope you didn't lose your time either. And I'm going to do that regularly. Hopefully, Mia will be able to join again as often as you will be able to find some time in your schedule.
Right.
So we'll see about it. But I think it was a pretty nice format. And please shoot any questions in my messenger, in the chat even right now, or whenever you want, if you need other information about what we did together. And there will be more. So I hope you had a nice time. And see you next time. Au revoir. À la prochaine.
À la prochaine.
See you next time.
À bientôt.
À bientôt et see you soon.
See you soon.
Ouais. À la prochaine. I like this one because it's very casual and cool. So
okay.
À la prochaine. À la prochaine. Salut. Ciao. Alors.